The big news in the cricketing world today, N. Srinivasan, President in Exile of BCCI, has been appointed as the new chairman of the ICC.
Srinivasan should not have been made the ICC chairman for the simple reason that if he has conflict of interest in India, and if the Supreme Court asks him to not be part of the BCCI running, then that man should not be heading ICC. After all, even ICC deals with its members on creating matters, and if the man is under cloud in his own country, how and why should he be heading the international body?
There is a moral position also, apart from the legal position, that while Mr. Srinivasan says that his conscience is clear, the fact that there is a case which is raging, should he then have taken the position? You know, he has shown himself to be a very stodgy person where following the legal path is concerned. So he has pursued it very diligently. Everything has been legally defined for him, and therefore he has reached this position where there is no legal bar to his accepting or becoming or assuming the chairmanship of the ICC. What also is a little, kind of quirky, and quirky is a mild word, is that almost every other cricket board seems to have agreed finally to his becoming the chairman.
I think if you have a man who is heading the ICC, is himself owning an IPL team, it's very clear where do his personal interests lie. Do his personal interests lie in the larger good of the game, or how does he look at the game? Does he look at the game that, look, test cricket shouldn't die and we have to save it, or does he look at how do we generate more profit? But its main focus is the trustee of the sport. And if the trustee itself only thinks in terms of profits and benefits, then I think the game might be harmed in the long run.